practicals in order to understand how strings can be practically implemented and manipulated. So we have already covered the by default string functions, that is str len, str rev, str cmp, cpy, etc. Right? So we have already covered them. Except that we are also going to perform this practical. Right? Now one more thing I want to tell you, that whatever function that you have implemented by using default function, like you have reversed the string by using str rev, you can also perform this task or program even without using the default function str rev, right? So suppose you want to reverse the string, suppose you want to find the length of string, suppose you want to compare two strings, you can do this by using default function, but you can also do this without using those default functions. So if you want to practice string functions, then please try to do all of this, function practicals without using the default functions, right? So in today's class, I am going to cover string practicals. I am going to cover first three practicals, that is find the length of string using strlen function, write a program to use strcmp and to check if the string which string is better, greater than or less than or equal to or something like that, and to concatenate two strings, right? So let me just copy this aim from here to my IDE. So here let me take new file, control N, and here I get inside this I'm writing the aims. So here is the aims, right? Now what can I do? To implement first practical, so we have already implemented it using the default function include stdio.h. Here it will be int main. Here inside this it will be return 0, right? Here it will be int or say char str having size 100, right? So let me save it as string. Now I have declared a string. One thing I need is length, to find the length of a string. So I know that if I want to write this program using strlen, I can just write strlen str, and here I am assigning the value to len, right? And before that I have to take value from user, so that's why I am printing enter the string, and here it will be scanf, you can use percentage s and str, right? Also you can use get s. So after that you can do len equal to strlen str. So the length of str will be stored to integer variable len, and then you can print it as printf slash n the length of string percentage s is percentage d. So here you can write str, and here you can write len, right? So you can let me check this program if it is correct or not. So let me save this program, compile it and run it. Here I have forgot to put semicolon, so let me save it again, compile it and run it. What is an issue? strlen was not declared in the scope. Why is this error coming? Because I have not used include string dot h. So let me save this program again, compile it and run it. It is running correctly. I am entering comas, so it is saying the length of string is 5. So our practical is complete. But why I have even after explaining this in the default function, why I am explaining it now? Because I want you guys to know that how you can perform this program even without using strlen. So suppose I don't want to use this. So let me comment it. Right? I want to find the length of string even without using this. So what I can do? So here the user is entering something. So here I am entering my name. So after this, what I can do? So let me explain this with the help of an example. So I am opening one file. Here, what is happening inside? string, right? So here, suppose string is nothing but the character array which is ending with null. So here I am entering this value, Komal, right? And last but not the least is null character. I am taking this as index 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? So, sorry, 0, 1, 2, 3, 5, right? Okay. Now, what is happening? I am going to count this. If this is some alphabet, then I am going to count. Suppose initially my count is 0. If this is some alphabet, then I am adding 1 to it. So now my count become 1. Then it will go further. Now if it is some kind of value, some alphabetic character, then I am again entering. So now new count become 2. Here it will become, count become 3. Here count become 4. Here count become 5. When I am encountering null character, I should stop. So this is my logic. What is my logic? If I am giving it name as str, so let me just erase every extra terms over here. So suppose I am giving this name as str, then if str of I, because I know this is the value of I, index is there, right? If str of I is not equal to single quote mein null, then I am going to go further with the loop. So I am doing this until I encounter null character. So how I can implement this logic? To implement this logic, I can write a loop for I equal to 0, str of I is not equal to null, then do I plus plus, right? I hope you guys are understanding that what I am doing. Even if you don't want to do this, you can eliminate this, right? So I am starting I with 0 or 2, str of I is not equal to null, I am doing I plus plus. Inside this, I can either write length plus plus, which is initially 0, because every time I am entering, incrementing length by 1. If the character is not null, I am incrementing 1, right? So you can also take count over here, that is count plus plus, and here count. So it is basically your choice that what you want to use. If you don't want this, you can directly print the value of I at the end, because value of I will be similar with the value of length. So here, instead of here, I am writing count. So let me save this program, compile it and run it. What is an issue? I was not declared in this call. So here I am declaring I, compile, run, entering Komal again. You can see I am getting the correct output. So this is how you can implement a program even without using strlen function. So you can try to practice all of those string functions without using. So suppose you can try, you know the logic of reversing an array, right? So you know how to reverse an array. You can implement this logic in string as well to reverse a string. So you, if you don't want to use strrev, it is okay. You can, without using it, you can achieve this task. You can also compare two strings without using strcmp function. You can also copy strings. You can also concatenate strings. And you can perform all of the searching of character inside string and searching a substring inside string without using those functions. Try to do it bit by yourself. So this was the first practical. So I am done with it. So I am erasing it from now. Second practical is write a program that read two strings and compare them using the function strcmp. So we have already done this, but we have not print the message that first string is equal, less or greater than the second one. So while comparing the strings, I have told you that whenever two strings are being compared, so here let me open my whiteboard. Here let me erase everything and explain it. Whenever I am comparing two strings, what is happening? Suppose I am taking first string as A, B, C, right? So this is character array A and character array string. Here it is D, E, S, right? And here it is this. So what it will do? It will start with comparing ASCII value of this character and ASCII value of this character. So it will do ASCII value of A minus ASCII value of D. So if it is not a zero, that means this both characters are different. That means this both strings are different. Suppose here it is A, A itself, A, E, S and A, B, C, right? So it will give zero. So it will go further with this and it will check until it encounters null character. So if it encounters null character and all the difference between the ASCII values of characters are zero, that means the string is equal, right? Suppose this is greater than this, that means if the ASCII value of this is greater than this, that means this string is greater than the second one. You can also find length for that. So let me close this. Now to implement the second practical here, what I can take? I just have to remove this. I need two string str1, str2. Inside this I am doing 100. I don't need this. I need L1 and L2. That is length 1 of string str1 and length of str2. Right. So enter string 1. After that I am entering s1. So let me just erase this extra comment and copy this now and paste it over here for string 2. Here it will be s2 and here let me do slash n. Right. So now how can I find length? I can also use function, or either I can also do it without function, but I am using function strlen of str1. So now l1 contains the length of string 1. strlen, here it will be str2. Now what I will check, if l1 is greater than l2, what does this mean? If l1 is greater than l2, I can directly say that first I will use strcmp, compare, right? strcmp of str1, str2, right? And here it will be x. So I have to declare x over here. Now if the value x is 0, that means both of the strings are equal. So here I can write directly, if x equal to 0, that means printf both of the strings are equal, right? If it is not, like else, that means one of them is having a greater length and another is having lesser length. So I am again comparing, if l1 is greater than l2, then printf slash n, say percentage s is bigger string than percentage s, and here it will be str1 and here it will be str2, right? And in else part, what I'm going to write in else part, I will just, else means L2 is less than, L1 is less than L2. So here we have to just change this to 2 and here it will change to 1. Let me just save this program and check if it is correct or not. Here it will be str. Compile it and run it. I am entering KOMAL, KOMAL. So both of the strings are equal, right? But what if I am writing, here I am doing Komal and here it is Langalia, my surname. So Langalia is bigger string than Komal. So this is how you can perform a program of comparing two strings using strcmp and print the greater one. So this practical is over. Now write a program so that it read two strings and concatenate them using appropriate string function and print the resulting string. So which function is used for this? Default function strcat concatenate is used for performing this program. If you have not watched my videos of string functions, then please go to watch that video, because I have already covered this concept in that video, right? So I'm not going to repeat that concept. I hope you enjoy this class and understand the concept. If you have any doubt, you can comment below the comment section and ask me. Thank you so much.